Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hello. If you're not new here, welcome back. I got a treat for you today. If you don't know me, my name is Des. I go by Desb, and you are at my YouTube channel. If you haven't already, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that little bell so you never miss a video from me. Today, I'm going to be talking to you guys about how to get sponsored. I'm going to give you four different ways that you can make your brand something that is sponsorship material. This is a really big question I get a lot just because I do have sponsorships and I've gone through quite a few companies. And so people are like, Des, like, how do I get with X? How do I get with O? Kisses and hugs, get it? So I figured I'd sit down and make this video so it's just kind of, you know, coming from my mouth. You can hear me talk about it and I don't have to be DMing y'all all the time the same answers over and over. So first and foremost, what is a sponsorship, right? A sponsorship is basically you adding value to a company and in turn the company hopefully adding value to you. My favorite thing about sponsorships and why they were so special to me in the beginning is because you get the chance to work with companies and network within that company for, first off, free stuff. Second off, you can often do giveaways, which a lot of people like on social media. And three, you also have the opportunity to represent a brand, and I think that that is a super special opportunity. There are a few different ways that you can go about getting sponsorships. One would be reaching out directly, and two would be them approaching you. So a few different ways that you can go about kind of presenting yourself to a company is, first, you have to invest in them. For the most part, companies aren't gonna come to you if they don't see that you've invested in their product before. That's kind of like me wanting to be an Adidas athlete and not owning a pair of Adidas shoes. How am I gonna represent a company that I've never been actually invested in? Get on their radar by purchasing their products, whatever it may be, and wearing them or using them, tagging them in stories, posts, etc., even on Twitter or something, or, you know, make a YouTube video about them and then share it on Instagram and tag them, whatever. When companies see that you've invested in them and that you've been using their products, and then they see people respond to you and using their products, that's when they're gonna know that you are worth the time and the money for them to invest in you, and in turn, hopefully bring in money to the company. Having a good following is obviously a first start. You don't have to be a huge page to get your first sponsorship. My first sponsorship, I had like 3,000 followers, maybe 2,000. I was with Rev Labs Supplements. They were a startup company and I was a startup fitness page. So depending on where you're at currently in your fitness journey and through your social media reach is going to be dependent on the kind of sponsorships that you are gonna go after. So if you're someone that's new into social media, I would suggest starting small. That just gets you on people's radar. It also gives them the opportunity to repost you and reach more people, and then more people will find you. So any type of clothing or supplement line, or, you know, I don't know, random, you know, band companies or bracelet companies, anyone that kind of wants to collaborate with you, when you're a smaller page, go ahead and collaborate with them. That's not an issue at all. That's what I did at the beginning. I did as many collaborations as I could just because it helps to get your name out there as well as build rapport within the community. From there, as you continue to grow your social media, that's when you start to almost outgrow certain sponsorships. So once I was with Rev Labs, I ended up growing so fast through my social media that other companies started to come at me. At this point, I had never signed a contract or anything like that, so I was kind of just like, freaking free willy. So from there, I ended up picking up Unico Nutrition and had been with them for over a year, and then I found Paragon Fitwear. So obviously that is really fitting my needs right now. I am no longer with Unico Nutrition, for those that are wondering. It is a conflict of interest for bodybuilding.com. I have nothing against the brand. I have nothing against the supplements. It has nothing to do with that. It is just a conflict of interest, and so that is why I'm no longer with them. side note. As you continue to grow your social media, bigger companies will reach out to you and in turn be able to collaborate more often. And this doesn't even have to be sponsorships at this point, just the opportunity to do something for a company or post for a company. Sometimes they will pay you to post about them, which then you can make easy money, or they will exchange a product for a post. So there's an upcoming collaboration that I'm working with, and it's called Pop Your Pup, which is freaking cute. But it is a pixelated, like cartoon character picture of your dog. So they pop it, like animation, cartoon, and they put it on a t-shirt. And so they wanted to collab with me knowing that I love my doggo and that I would be interested for a collab. This is a great opportunity for me because it's something that I love and would be such a cute gift for me to get anyone or for others to get someone else. And so I can share that with you guys on social media, as well as be able to get an exchange of product for a post for them. Sometimes it is annoying posting for a product, you know, like, I'm sorry, but I see PE science all the time on my feed, and like, that's freaking annoying. So there comes a certain point where like being paid to post, that can really damage your rapport on your social media, just because no one wants to see paid posts, every single post. That's annoying. However, if you have the opportunity to do it, go for it if that's what you want to do. Now, in terms of continuing to grow the opportunities to sponsor with bigger companies, this is going to come from, like I said, continuing to grow your social media. So for now, say I wanted to be sponsored by Lululemon. I don't even think they do sponsors, but say I wanted to. I would probably have to be higher up in the industry to achieve a sponsorship like that. Now, there's some companies that will take anyone and they go for the real versus the fake. So I totally think that companies can get more out of people that actually want to support their company versus people that have the numbers. So for instance, bodybuilding.com, they have a range of athletes that are anywhere from 10K followers to 500K followers, a million followers, etc. So on that grand scheme of things, they're looking more for people that will bring and add value to their brand that they love and truly believe in. Now for other people, other companies such as 1UP, I don't know, I'm just throwing names in there. This has nothing to do with 1UP, but maybe they're looking more for just people that have a higher reach and could bring in more money. So dependent on the company's values and missions, your opportunities could be different as well. When it comes down to it, sponsorships are not the make or break of whether you are fit for this industry and whether you deserve to be in this industry. Sponsorships are few and far between, especially because there are billions of people on Instagram. I guarantee you that there are people and companies that would love to work with me that don't know who I am, and that's okay. But someday, in some time, you might get stumbled upon, so you always wanna make sure that your content is great, you're smiling, you're happy, and you're giving off all the posy vibes. So a few things to recap on is, one, sponsorships don't mean poop, okay? It's all right, sponsorships are great, but half the time, honestly, you can make an impact without having a sponsorship. Look at Susie Kettlebell, okay? She has literally no sponsorships except for Rosa self-tanning. Other than that, she is self-made and she does her own thing. Same with Katie Hearn. She has like no sponsorships other than collaborating with certain brands and Ravish Sands. You don't need it. So, but I do think being a smaller Instagram page, sponsorships are great to perform better collaborations and network as well as get your name out there. Number two, make sure that you are constantly providing value and content on your page to where businesses will invest in you in turn for you to invest in them. Three, make sure that you are investing in the company before you're representing it. If you just jump into a pool of supplements that you've never tried, I promise you, you're gonna regret it. 100%. So make sure that you are knowing the company that you are wanting to represent. And number four, make sure that no matter what, you stay true to yourself and never ever let a sponsorship dictate your self-worth. Just because you might not be sponsored by the up-and-coming best brands ever doesn't mean that you can't make a way in this industry for yourself. I hope that this helped you guys a little bit. I know that it is such a confusing world on social media when it comes to sponsorships and how to get them and how to get in contact with them, but I promise you, just make sure that you are representing the brand before they want you to represent it. Make sure that you are tagging them. Make sure that you are engaging with them on Instagram. So comment on their posts, like their posts, watch their stories, just so that you can continue to get on their personal radar. And all in doubt, just like normal life, send them a freaking email or connect with them on LinkedIn, because it can never do any damage. It just shows that you're there. Shows that you're in there, like swimwear. I love you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that this helped just a little bit. Comment below what you want to see next time. Make sure that you like, subscribe, and hit the little bell. I love you. 'Cause I'm the light.